So right when we thought Danny Duncan was in the clear, he gets hit with a barrage of allegations against himself. And these, I would say, are much more serious because they involve him involving himself with females who were under the age of 18. According to Keemstar, she was 14 and the other three girls were 17 when they had some sort of interaction with Mr. Duncan. It's actually been almost daily thing for Drama Alert to release these videos on Danny, where Keemstar basically interviews these women accusing him of inappropriate things. I want to make it very clear that these are allegations with an unsubstantial amount of evidence, and with these types of claims, it's very important to remember that he should be considered innocent before being proven guilty in the court of law. And unless there's just some damning evidence like with the EDP situation we saw a few months back, I'm talking about chat logs, pictures, and recorded phone calls, then we should consider Danny innocent, at least of anything illegal. And these three girls all had their different stories with Danny, but they all say he reached out to them when they were underage and that they were sending adult messages back and forth. And all of them apparently at one time during their communication allegedly met up with him in person and had physical contact.
And I guess he went through my pictures, found my Snapchat, added me, and immediately sent me a snap, which I thought was like, I don't know, I really thought he was trolling.
So you start talking to him on Snap, how long until it's, you know...
Maybe for a week or two before he started asking for pictures and sending some himself.
And it's this latest girl to come out to me who has the most evidence. She has pictures of her kissing Danny, and she says that they met and were dating when she was only 17 and he was 23. She says this was all happening in California where the age of consent is 18, so technically if she is telling the truth, this would be illegal. Her proof is really just all of these pictures she had with him where it looks like they go on vacation together and are pretty much on par with pictures people take when they're in a relationship. I'm gonna be honest, guys, if you're 23 and still thinking about being with a junior in high school, I do think that's very strange. This guy acts very immature in his videos, and I think he really is that way in real life. You know, he's a very smart guy, but I feel like he can be very reckless. The bad thing for him is there's no real approach to address this without looking bad in some way. He looked like a genius after his first beef with that guy Aaron, and now only a week later he's under fire once again. Knowing my luck, he'll probably make a response right after I post this video, but part of me really does think he will go on without saying anything to try and keep it as far away from his name as possible. That is, unless more and more women keep stepping up and he's forced to address this head on. And if this is all a lie, shame on these women. People need to start getting serious legal punishment for false allegations, and this is the type of stuff that could destroy someone's entire life. This really does happen all the time, like with football players Sean Oakman, who had his whole life destroyed after a woman lied about him in the worst way possible. And let's make it clear, there's no screenshot of him asking for pictures or any sort of hard evidence besides these booed up photos with the alleged 17-year-old girl. The most suspect message I've seen from him is that he allegedly said a girl is gonna put him in jail in response to her messaging him about signing her bra.
I messaged him first and I said, hey, if you ever need like a bra in Houston, I've got you. And then he said, you gonna put me in jail, which is obviously implying that he knew I was underage.
The thing I really can't understand, if you're in the position he's in, is why you would even get close to doing something this stupid. If you were over 18, you should not be interacting with people under 18 at all. Especially knowing they're your fans really adds an extra layer to this to me. That's online, or especially in person. I know a lot of you will ask why the girls went to Keemstar and not the police, but apparently a couple of them had filed police reports in the past. So the only other reason I can think they might be lying is they might be angry fans who thought that Danny liked them, or that they were special to him because he flirted back on a few messages and then they got mad when he ghosted them. At least that's the case for the first three girls. I mean, this last one literally has pictures of them kissing. And if she was indeed 17 when they met, then that is crazy. The idea of her going to algebra and then going to chemistry class and then getting out of school and having chemistry with Danny Duncan, I mean, that's just fucked up. I just do not get it. Like, why talk to a high school kid when you can totally be bagging some beautiful women? This dude is famous and rich enough to date whatever type of woman he wants. And I just do not get this type of behavior. But let me know what you guys think. For Danny's sake, let's hope he can somehow clear this all up. You know, I feel like these allegations are a lot more serious. So yeah, let me know how you feel down below. Thanks for watching and subscribing today. As I know, it's been your boy, the Tan Superman. And another YouTuber out here needs to get covered, so it's been your boy. And I'm out. Peace!